Water and minerals. One of the most important things in our nutrition is not something we eat, but drink. And that thing is water. We can survive up to 3 weeks without eating, but can survive for only 3 to 4 days without water. This is because water is an essential component of protoplasm. About 70% of the body weight of a mammal is water. Functions of water. Water is one of the best known solvents for both inorganic salts and many organic compounds. In fact, it is also known as a universal solvent because of its unique ability to dissolve most of the things that go into it. This property gives water its many functions and makes it especially important to live. Water serves as a medium in which the various chemical reactions of an organism occur. It is an important component of the blood that helps the transportation of digested food substances from the intestines to other parts of the body. The transportation of excretory products from the tissue cells to excretory organs, such as kidneys, for removal, and the transportation of hormones from glands, where they are produced, to regions of the body which require them. It is also a major component of lubricant found in the joints and the digestive juices. In addition, water is needed to carry out many types of hydrolytic reactions, which take place during digestion. It is also required in homeostasis to maintain our body temperature, and by plants during photosynthesis. Water requirements. The amount of water needed in the body depends on the activity of the person and the environmental conditions. Water is lost from the body during many of our daily activities, which are as simple as breathing, excreting, and sweating. More exercises mean more sweat and more water loss. In some diseases like diabetes, the amount of urine excreted is increasing significantly, so the patients need more water than people without diabetes. To balance the amount of water loss daily, a normal, healthy, and ordinarily active adult in a temperate climate requires about 3 liters of water a day. In hot climates, slightly more water may be needed. Minerals. Mineral elements are inorganic salts that do not provide energy, but are vital for the proper functioning of our bodies. Minerals are obtained from other animals or plants. In humans and other mammals, some minerals are acquired in large amounts, while others are only needed in small amounts. The minerals that are needed in large quantities are calcium, phosphorus, sodium, chlorine, potassium, and iron. Today, we will discuss important minerals such as calcium and iron. Calcium. Calcium is mainly found in dairy products like milk, cheese, and eggs. Calcium is also available in soybeans, cereals, and dark green vegetables like spinach. Calcium is required for the building of bones and teeth. It is also needed for the normal functioning of the muscles and for the clotting of blood to prevent excessive loss of blood. Iron. Iron is found in the liver, all red meat, and egg yolk. It is also found in bread, flour, and dark green vegetables. Iron is a structural component of hemoglobin, myoglobin, and some enzymes, and so is essential for their formation. Trace elements. Minerals known to be needed in very small quantities are called trace elements. Iodine, zinc, and manganese are examples of such elements. Trace elements are normally consumed in food, and they function in various bodily processes.